Okay, so for this right angle triangle, this is location of center of gravity. So from 90 degree, we can find out this distance. So this distance, this is equal to 10 by 3. And along y direction, we can find out this distance. So this is also 10 by 3. Okay. But to find out x coordinate, that is xi and the yi, we need to measure the distance with respect to x and y axis. Okay. So first we will try to find out the x coordinate. So from y axis, measure this distance. Okay. So this will be the xi. So refer the actual geometry. So this is 10 mm and this is 10 mm. Okay. So to find out x coordinate from 20 mm, we have to subtract this 10 by 3 from this point to this corner point. Okay, total distance will be 20. From 20, subtract this 10 by 3, we will get the required distance xi. Okay, so this xi is equal to 20 minus 10 by 3. And to get the value for the y coordinate, so this is the y coordinate. Distance with respect to the x-axis. Okay. So this total distance, this is 35 mm. From 35 mm, subtract this 10 by 3. So we will get the required distance yi. So yi is equal to 35 minus 10 by 3. Okay. So I hope this is clear how to get the x coordinate and the y coordinate. And I'll put all these values in the observation table. Put the value of xi, yi. So for rectangle, x coordinate is 10 and y coordinate is 17.5. For quarter circle, this is 4r upon 3 pi x coordinate. So this is 4 into 20 upon 3 pi. So get this value. And y coordinate is same. It is 4r upon 3 pi. Then for right angle triangle, having the dimension 15 and 10, the x coordinate, this is equal to 10 by 3. And y coordinate, this is 35 minus 15 by 3. So it is 30 mm. For second right angle triangle, it is 20 minus 10 by 3. And this is 35 minus 10 by 3. Okay, so now find out this product AIXI and this AIY. Okay, for each geometry, rectangle, quarter circle, right angle triangle, and right angle triangle. Okay, so just give me these answers. Okay, so from this table, we will get the value for summation of the area. So summation of area, that is summation AI, this is equal to 260.84. Then summation AIXI, so this addition, summation AIXI, it is equal to 3250.1. then summation ai yi, this is equal to 5750.1. Now we have to find out the x bar and the y bar. Okay, so for x bar we have the formula summation ai xi divided by the summation of the area, and for y bar this is summation ai xi divided by summation of the area. Okay, so put this value in this equation and get the value of x bar. So x bar is equal to 12.467. And the y bar, this value is 22.04. This is millimeter. Okay. So if you want to locate this x bar and y bar, that is the centroid of the shaded area. So this is 20 mm. Okay. And the x bar value is 12.46. So this is the 10 mm. And y bar is 22. So total distance is 35. Okay. So half will be 17.5 somewhere here. Okay. So 22. This is the location of the center of gravity. So this is G. X coordinate is 12.46 and Y coordinate is 22.04. So this is how we can find out the centroid for the complex area. Okay, so note down the next problem. So in this problem, the cross section of the concrete beam is shown, and we have to find out the centroid of that cross section. So this is the concrete beam and this is the cross section area of that beam. So for this cross section we have to find out the center of gravity. So just tell me the given area, for the given area, which standard geometry we will use so that we will get the required area.